Afternoon.
Rafa, how are you injury wise ahead of this one?
Much better. We have apart from Jonjo and Elliot, the rest of the team fine. They have been training, so everybody is fit and available.
That's a nice selection headed then, isn't it? It sounds like you're going to have a few decisions to make in terms of your starting 11.
Yeah, not just the starting 11, also the 18 players that you have to put in the squad, because everybody's fine. So we have promised today to decide, because we have extra players on the pitch. So that is good news, because in the end, the competition always, I say, is positive for the team.
And a crucial time of the season to have these players back, isn't it? Because, I mean, you just look at the midfield and you've brought in Sean Longstaff, and Isaac's played a lot recently, but you're pretty stretched in there. To have them for the running now is a crucial time.
Yeah, always it's important to have everyone if it's possible, but especially at this time when you are playing for everything, then players could be more tired, could be it's more risky for everyone, because at this stage of the season they accumulate so many minutes that is when you have more problems. So it's good to have more bodies, more competition, and in the end has to be good for the team.
Is Shelby close?
It's close. Has been training outside, but we don't want to take any risks, so it's going his process. I think still we have to wait 1 or 2 weeks, it depends. But the problem with him is always that he wants to push, he wants to be on the pitch, he wants to train well with the team, and then we have to stop him sometimes.
How is Michael? We obviously spoke to him yesterday. He's had a couple of days training now. How is he adapting to life here in the Northeast?
I think he's fine. Training, he's okay. He's normally fit. He's a player that is has a good stamina, good pace, so it's quite mobile, quite dynamic, so it's okay. And now the question mark will be what will happen with the physicality of the Premier League, all these things that we know. What is the difference between the MLS and the Premier League? So all these things that we know, we'll see how he cope with that, but at the moment in the training sessions, he's okay.
Yeah, he certainly seems to have the right attitude. He was saying all the right things yesterday. Do you think he does have the mentality? Do you think he does have the game? I mean, we've seen in the past the likes of, I think off the top of my head, Cabella or Tolman, who really didn't adjust to the English game. Do you think Almiron is different to these guys?
I don't know them properly, you know, in terms of sharing with them a lot of time. But what I can say about Miguel, he's a nice lad, he's a worker, and he's training well. He was talking with the nutritionist already, so he's quite professional. So everything that we try to do with every player, he will do it. We were talking, for example, yesterday about the gym, when we have to train in the gym. He's already done some of the exercises that we have done, so I think he will be okay. Obviously, he can talk English, or he can understand good English properly, but he can talk Spanish with us. So in terms of what we want from him on the pitch, it's okay. I think it's just a question of to put him on the pitch and see how he cope with the tackles.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about the language, because that was one of the reasons, I think you said it earlier in the season, why Muto perhaps wasn't being involved as much. Will that be an issue at all with Almiron?
No, not for him. For some players, for everyone to come to another league, and especially the Premier League, is quite difficult. So they need time to adapt. And for some players, it's more difficult because they cannot communicate. But he can talk with a lot of players in Spanish, and he understands English perfectly. So it's not an issue for him.
Will he be in the squad for Monday?
I need to decide, because we have, as you say, too many players. But he has chances to be in the squad.
Okay.
Yes.
Rafa, just in terms of what Almiron was saying yesterday, talking about the record price tag being an honour rather than a pressure, and he's trying not to think about it in those terms. I'm guessing that's the attitude that you will try and cultivate with him when it comes to that record signing tag.
Yeah, for sure. Any player, they cannot think too much about the price. They have to think about what they can do on the pitch, what they can give the team. And I think he has the right mentality in terms of that.
And in terms of Wolves, they've been away on a warm weather training camp this week, and that's what you'll be taking the players on after the game on Monday.
Yeah, I know that they are away, and we will try to do it, because when you have so many days And especially when you have new players coming, I think it's important for everybody to know each other a little bit better, so you have more time to, because we don't go there on holidays. Some people think, oh, you go, we go for training, we do double training sessions, so I think I will have time to adjust things and for the players to know each other really well.
And having the friendly as well against CSKA in Moscow, I guess it's also a real positive to play a game, even if it's a friendly game, but to get that match practice in as well.
Yeah, give the players the opportunity to see how this hard work, no, can pay in a game. So I think just stay there and training is fine. But if you have the opportunity to see, especially the new players in this environment with the teammates, I think it will be positive too.
Just thinking about Wolves, they've had a fantastic season given that they're a newly promoted side. What have you made of their campaign overall?
I think they are doing well. They have a good manager, they have very good players. We talk about the new promoted teams, but they have spent more than 100 million, all of them. So it's not the same when you have another promoted team, for example, like Huddersfield, that they spend some money, but still, it's a big difference. If you see the players that they have champions of Europe, they have players international at any level. So they're a good team doing really well.
And it's fair to say after the game at St James's Park, you were left very frustrated by some refereeing decisions that you felt didn't go Newcastle's way. Obviously, you want the 3 points for the 3 points' sake, but is there any part of you that has that desire to almost even the scores a little bit by getting a result because of your frustrations in that game?
No, just because we want to get 3 points. Obviously, we knew after the game, watching the replay, that everything was wrong and we didn't deserve to lose the game, but we cannot change that. What we have to concentrate now in is this one. It's an opportunity for us because every game for us is a final. So this is the first one, and then we have to play all the finals with everybody concentrate and focus on that.
And I just wanted to ask you, given that bizarre pitch invader that they had in their last Premier League match when the cat went on the pitch against Everton, have you ever been involved in a game like that where an animal's gone on the pitch?
Not really. A ball pitch, yes, but no. No animals, no. That is something curious, but something that you have to try to stay calm and manage, that's it.
Yeah, Nuno seems to find it quite amusing on the sidelines, but I guess when you're winning, it's also, you don't really mind play stopping for a little while.
No, I think when you have to more or less have the same behaviour if you win or if you cannot, and try to be normal as much as you can.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Rafa, how is Antonio Baraka settling in now? You obviously had a few minutes last week.
Yeah, it's okay. Also, his English is worse than the English of Almirón, because obviously he talks Italian, but we can talk with him, we can communicate with him, so it's okay. He knows what we want, and then we are working on that. And this week away will be another opportunity for him to know the teammates and then see how we want to do things. So I think it's another one that will need some time, but at least he's very focused too.
Do you have to think about getting the English players to learn a bit of Spanish or Italian or whatever so that they can communicate better with them?
I would say now, and sorry about that, but you have problems because when you talk English, you think that everybody has to talk English. Then normally you are not the best in learning a second language, and I think it's a stat. It's not that I'm saying that. But if you have some good, clever players, that we have some of them, they learn quickly and they can communicate in Spanish with the others.
I agree, it's terrible. We are absolutely appalling. Another Monday game. Is it difficult to sit across a whole weekend and watch the other results happening while you're not playing?
No, not really. I think when you have this situation for a while, then you know that will be like that. You have to wait and you cannot change anything. So the only thing that you can do is be sure that you prepare your game properly, and that's it. And your players, they are not affected for what happened in the other pitches, so it's just to stay concentrated on your game.
It doesn't sometimes help to know what you're up against by Monday night?
Yeah, but sometimes it's positive, sometimes it's negative, and then because you cannot change anything, it's better don't focus on that and say, okay, what I have to do, perform with my team, and that's it.
I guess it's a bit of a frustration for some of the fans who have to keep going away on a Monday night, though.
Yeah, I have seen that normally our fans, they are travelling more than anyone, and the timing also has been really bad. So I don't know if it's just a coincidence, but it's a pity for our fans, because when you have so many following the team, I think that you have to consider also these things, but it's something that it doesn't depend on us too.
Thank you very much.
Good. Thank you. Cheers. Thank you.